Hello children, we are in a chapter called Magnetic Effect of Electric Current. It is a very important chapter in physics, and this chapter along with the electricity you are going to get 17 marks, and it is a revision chapter because this chapter is already completed in the classroom. Magnetic effect of electric current was discovered by Oersted. A conductor carrying electric current produces magnetic field around it. This statement is called magnetic effect of electric current. Where there is electric current, there is a magnetic field. Then what is magnetic field? Magnetic field is a region around a magnet where magnetic force can be experienced. Magnetic field comprises of magnetic field lines. What are the properties of magnetic field lines? Magnetic field or magnetic field lines are vector quantities. They have both magnitude and direction. Magnetic field lines are closed curves. They are directed from north to south outside the magnet, south to north inside the magnet. There is no chance that two magnetic field lines are going to intersect. Like poles repel each other and like poles attract each other. And we all know that how to draw magnetic field lines around a bar magnet. A very important part for the public examination. You have to write you have to remember the properties and diagram of magnetic field lines around a bar magnet. The next comes, a conductor carrying electric current produces magnetic field. The magnetic field produced around the straight conductor carrying electric current is in the form of concentric circles. And how to identify the direction of the magnetic field lines? Direction of the magnetic field lines can be determined by right hand thumb rule. Imagine that we have to hold the conductor by our right hand. Thumb indicates the direction of the electric current and finger tips represent the direction of the magnetic field lines. Then what happens when we allow the electric current to pass through a circular coil? When we allow the electric current to pass through a circular coil, we are able to get a very powerful magnetic field at the center of the coil, center of the circular loop, and the magnetic field obtained is uniform magnetic field because magnetic field lines are parallel lines. At this point of time, in the chapter we can understand there are three different types of magnetic field we come across. One is the magnetic field around the bar magnet, magnetic field around the straight conductor carrying electric current, magnetic field in the circular loop. Then, where we are applying this knowledge of magnetic field? We are applying the knowledge of magnetic field for making certain devices. The first devices we come across is solenoid. Solenoid is nothing but a coil of many number of turns of insulated copper wire wrapped closely in the shape of a cylinder. And when you see the magnetic field of a solenoid, outside the solenoid, magnetic field looks like a bar magnet, magnetic field of bar magnet. But inside the solenoid, we get uniform magnetic field at the center, very powerful magnetic field we are going to get. And this magnetic field is used to produce, to make electromagnets. Electromagnets are used in various gadgets like motor, generators, electric train, electric crane, electric cars, washing machine, mixies. They are all working under the principle of the electromagnets. Today's class, what we are going to learn is, there was a scientist by name Andre Ampere. He conducted an experiment. The experiment is like this. I write the experiment here. What he did is, he took a horseshoe magnet, a magnet in the shape of a horseshoe. It is a horseshoe magnet. I am writing this. It is horseshoe magnet. He took a horseshoe magnet. Horseshoe magnet is having, every magnet is having two poles, north pole and the south. And this is horseshoe magnet. This experiment was conducted by Ampere. Andre Ampere. You are all aware of the name Ampere. Ampere is the name of the scientist, and his name is kept for the unit of electric current. The SI unit of electric current is ampere, and the symbol of electric current is I. Now he took a horseshoe magnet. Now what he did is, between the poles of this horseshoe magnet, he kept one aluminium rod. We all know that aluminium is a good conductor of electricity, a light metal. We have a chapter called metals. In that they told it is a lighter metal. It is a lighter metal. And I name this aluminium rod as AB. This aluminium rod is kept between the poles of a powerful magnet. This experiment was conducted by Ampere. Ampere is the SI unit of electric current. Is that Ampere is the name of a person, and his name is kept as a unit of SI unit of electric current. This Ampere conducted this experiment. What is that? He kept an aluminium rod AB between the poles of a powerful Bosco magnet, and he connected this aluminium rod to a circuit. And we all know that the components of the circuit requires battery. Without the source, there is no use of the circuit, right? And to on and off, we require plucky. And to vary the resistance, we require a rheostat. These are all basic components of the circuit. And to measure the electric current, we require a device called ammeter. And the circuit is completed. See, we made a circuit. Try to understand. This is a horseshoe magnet. And there is an aluminium rod in between the poles of the horseshoe magnet, and aluminium rod is connected to the circuit. The circuit comprises of battery, plucky, rheostat, and ammeter. Right, now the circuit is open. This experiment was conducted by Ampere. What he did is very close. The observation part. In this experiment, when he closed the circuit, we all know that when circuit is closed, the current has to flow. Current comes like this, it goes back to the negative terminal. When he closed the circuit, what happens? This conductor, this is aluminium rod, suddenly tilts it. The conductor tilts like this, turns, it rotates. Now what he did is, when I complete the circuit, it tilts. He understood the direction. AB came in the front and B went back like this. It tilted. What he did is, he interchanged the terminals of the battery. Here it is plus and minus. The interchange. When he interchanged, he is able to observe the tilt is in the opposite direction. Now, first thing what happened? A came front, B went back. But in the second case, when the terminals have changed, B came front and A went back. Therefore, what he understood is the direction of the current and the tilt of the conductor is having some relation. He understood that. Whenever the direction of the tilt, direction of the turn, direction of the motion of the conductor depends on the direction of the electric current. If the direction of the electric current changes, direction of the tilt also going to change. That one experiment he did. Then what he did is, he changed the poles of the magnet. Now it is north and south, he made it ulta, south and north. Then also he is able to identify change in the tilt of the conductor. Therefore, he concluded that by performing this experiment, he concluded that whenever a conductor carrying electric current, you see, you try to understand now, AB is a conductor, AB is aluminium rod, it is a conductor. When you allow the conductor to carry electric current and that conductor is kept in the place in the magnetic field, the conductor is kept inside the magnetic field of the magnet, then the conductor experiences a force and that force is identified by the ampere. And that in the higher classes we are going to learn this, that force is called the Botar force. Therefore, this experiment is ampere contagion experiment. What is that experiment tells? It tells about the force experienced. Force experienced by a current carrying conductor inside the magnetic field. Inside the magnetic field. Try to understand. Very nice information to understand this. Here there is a magnetic field. That is a magnetic field of the Horseshoe magnet. In the magnetic field, if I keep a conductor carrying electric current, that conductor experiences a force. And that force is determined by the experiment conducted by the ampere. And that force is utilized to turn the motors. Therefore, this force is called the motor force. Here, the direction of the tilt of the conductor depends on the direction of the current as well as direction of the magnetic field. Try to understand. How many magnetic fields are there? That you have to understand first. Actually, here, the first one is the magnetic field of the magnet. There is a magnet. Imagine this. There is a magnetic field here. The magnetic field of the Horseshoe magnet. Magnetic field of the Horseshoe magnet is here. It is already there. It is a permanent magnetic field. Horseshoe magnetic field is having a magnetic field. When you put the switch, then it becomes a current carrying conductor. When the current carrying conductor produces magnetic field in the form of concentric circles, like this. Now, how many magnetic fields are there? Two. One is the magnetic field of the Horseshoe magnet. Another one is the magnetic field of the conductor carrying electric current, which is kept inside the magnetic field. Because of the two magnetic fields, they creates a force. That force acts on the conductor and makes the conductor to turn. The conductor is turned because of the interaction of the two magnetic fields. Which are the two magnetic fields? One is the magnetic field of the Horseshoe magnet. Another one is the magnetic field of the conductor carrying electric current. Therefore, ampere is explained that force experienced by a conductor carrying electric current kept inside the magnetic field. Now here, he is able to understand that the direction of the tilt of the magnet, direction of the tilt of the conductor, that is called the motion of the conductor, direction of the electric current and direction of the magnetic field. I write the three concepts here. One is directions of, one is direction of the magnetic field are interrelated. There is a direct relationship between the motion of the conductor, electric current and the magnetic field, directions. That is being able to understand the experiment conducted by ampere. Understand? I repeat once again. See, Henri Ampere, a scientist, he performed an experiment. In that experiment, he took a Horseshoe magnet. Horseshoe magnet is having a magnetic field. Every magnet is having a magnetic field. Between the poles of the Horseshoe magnet, he kept an aluminium conductor, aluminium rod. The reason of selecting aluminium rod is, aluminium is a light metal. It is a non-magnetic material. It is not going to attract by the magnet, but it is a good conductor of electricity. He kept aluminium there. And then he connected the aluminium rod to the circuit. Circuit comprises of battery, plug key, rheostat and ammeter. Now the question is, when he closed the circuit, this conductor, that is aluminium rod, tilts. When it starts tilting, he understood that there is a tilt should be based on a force. Simply a conductor cannot tilt. It is tilting because of the force. That force is due to the magnetic field produced by the conductor and the magnetic field of the Harshow magnet. There are two magnetic fields. The two magnetic field interacts and the force is on the conductor which carries electric current. Here he used rheostat. Why? Because when he increase the current, the tilt is faster. When you change the direction of the current, the tilt is also changes. Therefore, finally he concluded that there is a force acting on a conductor carrying electric current kept inside the magnetic field. And the direction of the motion of the conductor, this is the conductor, which direction it moves, the direction of the motion of the conductor is related to the direction of the electric current and direction of the magnetic field. Using this inferences of the experiment conducted by André Ampère, there was a scientist by name Fleming. The full name of Fleming is John Ambrose Fleming. Fleming, I write it here, Fleming. His full name is John Ambrose Fleming. He was considered as father of electronics. He was the person who made diode. He made one hand rule to understand the relationship between these three factors of this particular experiment. And that hand rule is popularly called Fleming's left hand rule. Left hand rule. Fleming's left hand rule is also called motor rule. This rule explains the working of a motor. Therefore, it is also called what? Motor rule. Very important for the examination point of view. André Ampère conducted the experiment and listed out the observation. The observation made by André Ampère is the directions of the motion of the conductor, electric current and magnetic field are related. How they are related? How to remember that relation? The relation can be identified by a hand rule. That hand rule is called the Fleming's left hand rule. Now see children, this is my left hand. How nice they made. Therefore, sometimes we feel that engineering is such a wonderful branch of science. Therefore, engineers are become very successful in life. Why? Because once you learn this particular content, your thinking level becomes very high. Therefore, all over the world, there is a great demand for engineers, irrespective of the branch. Therefore, there is a huge rush to become an engineer. You also can decide to become an engineer. Engineering means he is having a wonderful brain. The brain, the IQ, the intuition is like this. See, Fleming, what he did, how to use, how to understand this relation and how to remember this. He made a rule, hand rule. That hand rule is called Fleming's left hand rule. What he tells is, see, this finger is called the thumb. This finger is called the forefinger. This finger is called the middle finger or a central finger. What he tells is, stretch your thumb, forefinger and middle finger of the left hand, mutually perpendicular to each other. Mutually perpendicular means thumb is perpendicular to the forefinger, forefinger is perpendicular to the middle finger is perpendicular to the thumb. All of them are 90 degrees, x, y and z axis, x axis, y axis and z axis, mutually perpendicular to each other. And to remember this, there are three concepts. One is the motion of the conductor, another one is electric current, another one is, the third one is magnetic field. See, this finger is called the forefinger, right? Forefinger. Forefinger, the spelling of the forefinger starts with F. Forefinger indicates the direction of the field. Which field? Magnetic field. Therefore, forefinger indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Middle finger, we call this middle finger as what? center finger. Center finger indicates the direction of the current. Electric current is indicated by the middle finger. And the thumb indicates the direction of the motion of the conductor. How nice it is, see. Left hand rule, what it tells is, see, magnetic field is identified by the four finger. See, you have to remember this. Examination point of it is very important. This is a four finger indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Four finger. Yep. Remember, four finger indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Middle finger is also called what? Center finger. Therefore, the middle finger, in the textbook they are given middle finger. I write middle finger. Middle finger means center finger. Therefore, C, center finger indicates the direction of the current. And motion of the conductor is identified by the thumb. Thumb indicates the direction of the motion of the conductor. Therefore, Fleming's left hand rule or Mota rule states like this. Examination point of very important. Stretch thumb, forefinger, middle finger of the left hand mutually perpendicular to each other. Forefinger, I start with the forefinger. Forefinger indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Middle finger indicates the direction of the electric current. And thumb indicates the direction of the motion of the conductor. And the experiment was conducted by Ampere. And the explanation was given by a scientist by name Fleming. Fleming made a hand rule. That hand rule is called the Fleming's left hand rule. And it is also called the Mota rule. I explain it once again. See, now what I told you is, Andre Ampere performed an experiment. In that experiment, he kept a conductor carrying electric current kept inside the magnetic field. When the circuit is closed, this conductor tilts. The tilt of the conductor is mainly based on the force experienced by that conductor when it is kept inside the magnetic field. Now here there are three concepts are there. The tilt, the direction of the motion of the conductor. The tilt is called the direction of the motion of the conductor. Direction of the magnetic field, direction of the electric current. All the three are interrelated. That relation was identified by or explained by another scientist by name Fleming. And he formulated a rule called Fleming's left hand rule or a Mota rule. It states like this. Stretch thumb, forefinger, middle finger of the left hand mutually perpendicular to each other. Then forefinger indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Middle finger or a central finger indicates the direction of the electric current, and thumb indicates the direction of the motion of the conductor. This is the idea you have to understand in this particular unit. Here, in the textbook, they are given one statement. See, what he did is, he put arrow marks like this. So, very nice things to understand this. This is the direction of the magnetic field according to him. The magnetic field is like this. Electrons are moving like this. Electrons are moving like this. If there is a magnetic field like this, electrons are dropped. Now the electron may not go straight. It is going to tilt. And which direction it is going to bend, that you have to understand. Like this, the answer is very simple. When the electricity is opposite to the direction of the flow of electrons. Electrons are down means electricity is moving upwards. This is electricity. Electric current. It is like this. Now in which direction the conductor moves? To understand this, we have to use this. See, Four finger indicates what? The direction of the electric current. Then, therefore, I should keep like this. Four finger indicates the direction of the magnetic field. Middle finger indicates the direction of the electric current. This one. Middle finger indicates the direction of the electric current. Therefore, conductor is moving away from you. It is, see, this is the motion of the conductor. This thumb indicates the direction of the motion of the conductor. Is thumb is indicating towards you or away from you? The thumb is indicating away from you. Therefore, conductor is moving away from you. Magnetic field is direct, is shown by the direction is shown by the forefinger. Electric current direction is shown by the middle finger. And thumb indicates the direction of the motion of the conductor. Now, that electrons are going to move that side. That's away from you. That way you can able to understand this particular hand rule. Hand rules are very much important to understand the working of a motor. Now we are in the very important part of this particular lesson. Now we have some logic. We have some information. We have some knowledge related to magnetic effect of electric current. That we know what is magnetic field, what are the different types of magnetic field around a state conductor, circular conductor, and what is solenoid, Fleming's left hand rule, Ampere's experiment. This is all information we know. Now we are going for practical application of this particular content. Therefore, you have to think. The practical application of magnetic effect of electric current we can understand by the working of a very popular device used by each and every person all over the world is motor. Motor, don't be the impression motor means it is to lift water. No. Many parts, many devices what we use in our day-to-day life, all of them having electric motors. For example, fan. Anything which rotates, starting from the drilling machine to fan to mixie to washing machine to even CD drive, yeah, many things. How many things which are blenders, sweepers? These are all things. Even water motor. Everything is having a very basic concept called motor. Even in computers, we have motor because your computer, the mother chip is there. That has to be cooled. Therefore, there is an internal motor. In cars, there are motors. In AC, there are motors. Everywhere, we can find the motor. The working of a motor is mainly based on the magnetic effect of electric current. Therefore, the use of magnetic effect of electric current is widely used in many electrical appliances used by man. Now, first thing is motor. Motor means what? First, we decide. First, we understand this. Very important thing, multiple choice they ask question because these are very basic physics. Motor is a device. Device is one which has to convert energy from one form to another form. Then in motor, what form of energy is converted into what form? Motor is a device which converts electrical energy. Which converts electrical energy. You have to provide electrical energy to a motor. Electrical energy into mechanical energy. Mechanical energy. Very important information. Don't be in the impression. Don't study all these things only refers to the public examination. It is a basic knowledge it is. In day-to-day life we use motor. Therefore we have to use for the whole life it is. This information is for the life. What is motor? Motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. In electrical fan, every household is having fan. The fan is having a motor. What is that device? When we supply electrical energy, it rotates. The rotation is called the mechanical energy. Mixie. When we put electrical energy, it rotates. Electrical energy is converted into mechanical energy. That device is called the motor. Right? What is a motor? The first question over. What is motor? Motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. energy. The next question arises, what are the types of motors? Is there any types of motors? Yes, we have two types of motors, AC motor and DC motor. AC means alternate current motor and direct current motor. Direct current motor means a small plain motor, it is called a simple motor. We call it as a simple motor. All mixies, fans, they have AC motor. The working is more or less same. Therefore, the types of motors, we have two different types of motor, AC motor and a DC motor. What is motor? Motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. The input is electrical. We have to give electricity. It has to give mechanical energy. That's simple. Now, this motor works on which principle? Principle of motor. The principle of motor is force. This principle is identified by Henry Ampere. The principle of motor is force experienced by current carrying conductor kept inside a magnetic field. This is the principle. The principle of a motor is based on a force experienced by a current carrying conductor. The force has to be experienced by a current carrying conductor kept inside the magnetic field. Inside the magnetic field, you have to keep a conductor and you have to give a current to it. When you give a current to the conductor experiences the force. In that force, motor works. The next is working of a motor. Working of a motor is explained by a hand rule called Fleming's. You know that? Fleming's left hand rule. Fleming's left hand rule help us to understand the working of a motor. The four things I have written here. What is motor? Motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. There are two types of motors, AC motor and DC motor. AC motor is alternate current motor. DC motor means direct current motor. We are going to learn this. DC motor, simple motors. Motors works on the principle of force experienced by a current carrying conductor kept inside a magnetic field. If you keep a conductor carrying electric current inside the magnetic field, the conductor experiences a force. And based on that force, motor works. And then, working of a motor can be explained by a hand rule that is called the Fleming's left hand rule. It states that stretch thumb, forefinger, middle finger of the left hand mutually perpendicular to each other. Forefinger indicate the direction of the magnetic field. Middle finger represent the direction of the electric current. And thumb indicate the direction of the motion of the conductor. Using that, we are going to explain the working of a motor. Today's class, we don't want to explain the working of a motor. First, we have to understand the description of the motor. What is motor? How it looks? See, now I write it here. Concentrate. See, this is the simple motor. This is simple motor. If I dismantle it, I get the parts. Here I can see the magnet. Here there is called the armature. And here it is called the commutator. Therefore, first we have to understand how it looks, and then we start learning the working of a motor. The intricacies of the motor we learn in the next class. But what are the parts are there in this motor, we are going to learn in this class, right? See, simple electric motor. See children, I already explained this in the classroom. This is mark switching area, guaranteed area. If you learn this, you get marks in public examination. That, see, SLC is so simple it is. Once you decide to get 90%, you easily get 90%. But you have to decide, make mind and sit and read.
Everything is provided by us. Only thing is you have to concentrate. See, electric motor
is made up of a rectangular coil. Inside the motor there is a coil. I write the coil in this shape. This is a coil. See, it is a rectangular coil. This to write, SLC students find it difficult now. What? This is the structure. It is a coil. And this coil, because we have to explain the working. Today I am not going to explain the working. Next class. And now understand which are the parts of the motor. And I name this as ABCD. I think you are capable of writing this. So simple it is. What is this ABCD? ABCD is a coil. I write it here. One part I write. So simple it is. What is ABCD? ABCD is a coil. Right? Simple. You can write wrong. One rectangle and you have to name it as ABCD. So simple it is. This is a coil. Then the question arises, this coil is made up of what? Always coils are made up of insulated copper wire. Electrical wires are nothing but copper wires. Therefore, the sentence you have to make English. What is the sentence? Electric motor is made up of a rectangular coil of very fine insulated copper wire. A, B, C, D. That is the first line. The next is, this coil is connected. This coil is connected. A is one line, B is one line. Connected to two copper split rings. There are two cups of copper. Cup. You know the cup? Two cups of copper. A is connected to one cup, D is connected to another cup. And these two are made up of copper, and these two rings are called copper split rings, because there is a gap here. Split it is. There is a gap here. Therefore, these two are called copper split rings. I name them as X, Y. This is coil and this is copper split rings. I write it here. X, Y. What is this XY stands for? Copper split rings. Copper split rings. Spelling you have to see. Split rings. Copper split rings. Electric motor is made up of a rectangular coil of very fine insulated copper wire ABCD. Coil is connected to two copper split rings X and Y. Right? And this coil and split rings, when you take a motor, you get both in one unit only, like this. Here coil is also there, split rings also there. The coil and split rings, both together, we call them as armature. This is called the armature. Armature comprises of two parts. One is the coil, another one is the split rings. These two together called, we call these two together as armature. These two together called what? Armature. This armature is welded to a rod. Like this one rod is there, see? On rod. It is called the axle. It is called the axle. Axle gives us axis. Therefore, this armature is made to rotate on its axis. In the axis, it is made to rotate. This is dotted line I represent as an axis. Here we can find an axle, one roller of metal. When I rotate like this, the whole thing rotates. When I rotate this ABCD, this also rotates. And the full unit is called what? Armature. This part is called what? Coil. This part is called what? Copper split rings. Simple.
Next is this coil. Now see here. This is copper coil, and this is split rings. This coil should be kept between the poles of a magnet. Here, if you see, you can see the magnet. Between the magnet, you have to keep the coil. The coil should be kept between the poles of the magnet. This side, copper split rings are there. See, remove. This is a coil. These are both coil and split rings. This coil should be placed between the poles of a magnet. Same thing. Now I write here magnets. For small boxes you have to write. You can share this. These are all you have to learn. Learning is always beneficial. You have to learn with an interest. You should have interest to learn. A person is having interest to learn, he definitely progresses in life. Learning is continuous. Learning is throughout our life we have to learn. This is north and south. Magnet. Right? Coil is placed between the poles of the magnet. Coil, copper split rings, magnet. Three parts are over. The magnet is named as what? NS. Now I write here. What is NS stands for? North and South Pole of a magnet. I simply write magnets. Right? Simple. Now, this coil and copper split rings together called armature. The split ring part, I use, see here. There are two cushions. Cushions means there are two brushes. Brushes made by graphite. Graphite means, you know, the pencil lead. Pencil lead is graphite, like that. By the pencil lead cushions are there, and we call them as carbon brushes. There are two brushes here. See here, if you can see that there are two brushes, two hands are there. They are called the brushes inside this. If you, I think everybody has purchased a motor. You can see that there are two brushes. The brushes here, the copper split ring should be attached to carbon brushes. Simple like this. See, over motor is over. You can easily dismantle. See, one motor dismantle. This is called the armature. It is having two things, coil and split rings. Coil should be placed between the poles of a magnet, and the split ring should be attached to two carbon brushes, and motor is over. Simple. And this carbon motor, this two are called the carbon brushes. I call this as B1 and B2. Brush means B. B1 and B2. Brush 1, brush 2. We call B1 and B2. I write it here. B1, B2. I can write B1 and B2. I can write P and Q. In the textbook, they have given P and Q. Anything you can write. Name. B1 and B2. Carbon brushes. Carbon brushes. B1 and B2. Now, these two carbon brushes, we have to connect to a battery. Therefore, the carbon brushes should be connected to a DC source, cell, or a battery outside. This is plus and this is minus. This is a DC, direct current source. DC source, external. See how many parts are there, why it is difficult to write. This fetches you 3 marks in the public examination. Very important part for the examination point of view. I'm talking about the explanation part or a diagram part of the electric motor. Electric motor is comprises of a rectangular coil of very fine insulated copper wire ABCD. Coil is connected to two copper split rings X and Y. Coil and copper split rings together called armature. Armature is made to rotate on its axis. Coil is placed between the poles of a powerful magnet NS. copper split rings are connected to two carbon brushes B1 and B2 in textbook diagram P and Q. B1 and B2. Carbon brushes are connected to a DC source externally. This part, this much, what are I told? And this is the parts. A, B, C, the coil, X, Y is the copper split ring. Together for armature, NS is the magnet, B1 and B2 are the carbon brushes. And if you write this much, you get 3 marks. I don't think so, it is difficult to write. It is easy to write. Nothing. 10th standard, 15 to 16 years of age, children. If they concentrate, they can do wonders. You concentrate and write. First, today's class, write this diagram. Write and practice. And in the examination, what they give, draw a neat diagram of the electric motor and explain. What is the explanation? DC motor or electric motor is made up of a rectangular coil of very fine insulated copper wire. First line. Second line. Coil is connected to two copper split rings X and Y. Second line. Third line. Coil and copper split rings together call armature. Fourth line. Armature is made to rotate on its axis. Fifth line. Coil is placed between the poles of a powerful magnet. Sixth line. Carbon brushes are attached to two carbon brushes B1 and B2. Seventh line. Carbon brushes are connected to a DC source. 10 standards you can write 7 sentences, right? This much you have to write. And this is regarding electric motor. I repeat once again. See, the main application of magnetic effect of electric current is the construction of the motor. What is motor? Motor is a device which converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. There are two different types of motor, AC motor and DC motor. We are going to learn about DC motor. It is a simple motor. And motor works on the principle of force experienced by a conductor carrying electric current kept inside the magnetic field. This experiment was conducted by Ampere. The working of a motor is explained by Fleming's left hand rule. Tomorrow's class we are going to learn about the working of a motor. Today's class we are going to identify the parts of the motor. Motor, electric motor, parts is coil. ABC is a coil. It is made up of a very fine insulated copper wire. Coil is connected to two copper split rings X and Y. Copper split rings. And coil is placed between the poles of a magnet. Copper split rings are attached to carbon brushes. Carbon brushes are connected to a DC source. These are the parts. Labeled. There is no need to label because you have to write ABCD. And next line you have to write like that. What I written like that you have to write. You get 3 marks.